out there, my YouTube fam and peeps. As you can see, we have 5 Morgan silver dollars sitting right here in front of you. Well, what we're gonna do is we're gonna have some fun. That's right. So, what are we gonna do with these coins? You're probably wondering and asking. Well, the question is very simple to answer. As you can see, I got me some wax, I got me some cleaning solution, and I got me a Dremel with a whole bunch of bits. As you can see, front and back, I got a lot of Dremel tools. So, we're gonna have fun. I'm gonna tape one of these bad boys down, and I'm gonna do a half cleaning on one of them, and then we're gonna compare them to, or compare it, should I say, to the other 4, and see if you can tell the difference of which side looks cleaner and looks better than the rest of the 4 coins. So, without further ado, let's have a little fun here, shall we? Okay now, here's how we're gonna do this. As you can see, we're gonna choose, that Morgan right here in my hand. As you can see, she looks pretty dirty. She is 1897, I think. I mean, you can see on the back, she looks pretty good. No mint mark. But the reason why I'm going to clean these coins is because I know one thing about these coins that's very, very important. They're fake. That's right. So, without further ado, let's move those 4 aside, grab that one, and let's tape her down. Oh my gosh, she's gonna struggle so bad. There we go. We got her. There we go. Now she's properly taped down. Okay, I'm not gonna use a clean Dremel bit to clean her. I mean, as you see, I got one right there. I am gonna swap out the dirty Dremel bit right there with this clean one when I go to wax her. And she's gonna love it. Love it so much. So, let's spray her down and get her wet. Here we go. Oh my god, she's so wet. Is no. No, she's too wet. Here we go. As you can see, we are cleaning her. I will give her a wet wipe wipe down. Wow, that just does not sound right. A wet wipe 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 down. That's a tongue twister for ya. As you can see, I am doing a really, really good job. I rubbed her down so good. So good. I don't know if you can really see it that well, but it's all good. Let's zoom, let's lean over and see. Can you see her? Can you see the clean spot? Oh my god, that's the most baddest shape. Can you find her wet spot with some flour? Well, as you saw, oops, I moved you too far. There you go. Bring you down a I'm using a ring light to hold my phone. I have a voice mod hooked up to my phone so I can have some fun with this. And as you saw, we did exactly what we said we were going to do. We cleaned her. So give me one more second. I need to change out. In fact, yeah, I'll just see my voice mod. How's that? And as you can see, wow, look at how dirty that is. And that's just from, that's smooth. That's smooth too. Like a baby's butt. Holy crap. I didn't know coins could be that smooth. Oh yeah. Well, now it's time for a little bit of wax on, wax off. That's right. You heard me.
Wax off. Wax off.
So, without further ado, let's apply some wax to the drummer head and see what happens. It's gonna be fun. Wow, I'm just shooting wax everywhere. Wax on, wax off. So let's see here. Oh, no. There we go. My demo has idiot problems. As you notice, I did not take the tape off her because most likely chances if I did, that would cause her to move around as I'm doing this. And from what I can see, wow. Okay, now. That was wax. Gotta find me a dry rag somewhere. Oh, here it is. It's always good to have one of those, too. Oh, wow. She's pretty nice compared to the other four that look sort of dirty and disgusting. But, hey, what you say? Let's take this tape off. Oh wow, she's been sitting in her own water. She's been too wet. Too wet. And you can blame her for being too wet. Oh wow. I don't know if you can actually see this, but can you see the line of where I cleaned and polished her, basically? I mean, look at that. You can see the dirt and dinge right there. She looks really, really nice on the other side. I gotta admit this, that polishing and that demo does a good job. I mean, even I can see it like this. I can see the line. Okay, it's not exactly center, but it's there. But here's what I don't suggest you do. Okay, the reason why I'm cleaning that one, this is called damaging a coin, basically. But this is a fake silver dollar. That's fake, that's fake, that's fake, that's fake. Like I said, it's fake. Real silver, I can tell you this why. It's because first, I weigh them. If they don't weigh 26.73 grams, I mean, give or take a gram or two for wear and tear and time and stuff like that is acceptable. But this weighs 20 grams. These other ones weigh anywhere from 19 through 20 grams as well, which means they're short by the 6 to 7 grams of weight. And then for the visible condition you can see of these coins, they shouldn't weigh that low. So these are mold cast coins. They're fake, they're useless, they're just for decoration. They're not for collecting. But why you don't want to wash your coins with anything that is harsh? I mean, say, for instance, don't use, let's say, that. When I say don't use this, look, these bristles are like stiff. Why this is dirty is because I've used it to clean fake coins before to see, you know, if I can make them look a lot better and As you can see, the antiquing lights, the stick, and the bristles. Because all they stick on these things is antiquing. They want to make them look old so that people will buy them. I bought 25 of these, and they cost $100 total out of pocket cost for 25. So each one of these five coins, is $4 a piece. That's not including the other fake ones I got as well that came with this 25-piece collection. But as you can see, polishing her, even though she's fake, does make her look a lot nicer. In one of my future videos, I will probably take my Dremel, a carbide blade, and we're going to cut it in half. And we're going to see what she looks like on the inside. Is she still wet on the inside? Or is she just fake like the rest of her sister coins that she's sitting on? Well, until next time, my YouTube peeps, you guys have a wonderful evening. And always remember, hit those like and subscribe buttons and let me know that you enjoy my content. Until next time, bye.